up to almost a decade since the Avengers came out in theaters. I have to say this right now that this movie really aged a lot more when it comes to later films once we enter in phase two and three. To be perfectly honest, after watching all the characters make an appearance, less including Hawkeye, I'm aware that Hawkeye made an appearance in the Thor movie. Along with the development that they had before we reached up to this film, I wouldn't be this invested in the MCU without this film. Granted, I wouldn't say that I will watch the other films wherever I got the time, but every time I instantly think about the Avengers, it just really shows of how much that the MCU really had a plan when it comes to the first three phases of their franchise. Every once in a while, once I watch this movie from time to time when it comes to its characters and action-packed sequences, it really feels like this movie really didn't felt outdated whatsoever. I mean, granted, when it comes to the animation and the effects, you can say that, but every time I instantly see the Avengers meet each other for the very first time and completely trying to grow our alliance as we completely see them return in Age of Ultron, this movie really feels like the crossover of what crossovers should be. Well, minus Justice League. Since all the other movies are leading up to this film with all the other characters meeting each other while also working together, I have to admit that the pacing in this film, along with most of the other characters, they really need to put the writing skills to the test in order to make the pacing, along with the other characters, work out for this film. And all I can say is that they really know how to deliver it. Tony meeting Bruce, who is being played by a different actor that I'm gonna get to later, along with meeting other characters, Captain America, Thor, Black Widow, and Hawkeye, along with the pacing of these characters just trying to get along, I have to admit, they really know how to make the elements in this movie work out for future sequels involving the solo films and the Avengers films. Every time I instantly look at Tony Stark in this film, he is still the same as he was in his two solo films. But when it comes to Thor, Captain America, and Hulk, I have to admit that the fact that they have different character developments after meeting each other for the very first time really proves of how much that this film is truly a one of a kind that should never be rebooted. And considering that Loki is the antagonist in this film, I understand that people were expecting this after watching Thor, but if I actually watch this movie and only review this movie only when it comes to the MCU, I have to admit that having Loki as the antagonist will probably be a lot more weaker. I'm not saying this because Loki is a terrible winning character, it's just that after watching future villains in this franchise, mainly Ultron and Thanos, I'm going to assume that these six Avengers won't be able to take down Thanos on their own, and they need help from other Avengers in order to make it this an even playing field once we reach to the climax of Endgame. Granted, Loki is in an alliance with an army that ends up destroying New York City, but for me personally, if you would completely take out the army and just replace it with other villains, it would probably make the Avengers deal with a horrible situation by being outnumbered. But then again, this army was the same army from Avengers Endgame, and completely seeing them in this movie, they can easily take down the Avengers if only Iron Man didn't use a nuke to destroy the warship in space. So if you really ask me, I can easily tell that with Thanos in this movie, I'm pretty sure that they would easily win the war, but at the end of the day, they didn't have Thanos on their side. But to be perfectly honest, these characters haven't been experienced when it comes to facing off other villains. Mainly the solo films, along with Age of Ultron, which has the most action-packed when it comes to these characters working together. And the fact that this leads to probably one of the most difficult breakups when it comes to Civil War. But again, I'm gonna discuss most of that in Civil War in phase three. All in all, I gotta say that this movie's runtime, regardless of my somewhat nitpicks to it really does its justice to be a really great film. Seeing these characters on screen after watching those solo movies really makes this movie probably the best way to have these characters have some kind of introduction after those solo films. Captain America trying to adjust the world in the present day, unlike in the 1940s where he was born during that time. Thor trying to stop his brother from causing utter chaos in New York. Along with Iron Man, Tony Stark himself realizing that there's more going on outside of the planet Earth. For me personally, these moments right here really makes this movie a lot more better when it comes to how old it is, so that you can easily see the later films taking these elements and try to make these characters a lot more important and more developed as we get into more films in phase 2 and 3. One of the characters I need to discuss is Bruce being played by Mark Ruffalo and not Edward Norton from The Incredible Hulk. I need to be perfectly clear here, if we actually had Edward Norton in this film, I'm pretty sure that there's not gonna be a lot of changes. We've mostly see of how Edward Norton reacts to most of the questionable decisions in The Incredible Hulk, so him being in this movie won't probably be a good thing. Granted, I did like his character, but seeing Mark Ruffalo in this film of how he's portrayed as the Hulk in this and the fact that he has a different makeover compared to how Edwin was portrayed in The Incredible Hulk, I'm going to admit that seeing more of the Hulk in the Avengers movie along with Thor Ragnarok once we get into that, I'm going to assume that they pretty much want to have the Hulk be mostly a secondary Avenger in these types of movies. Mostly at the fact that he doesn't get much attention as he does in The Incredible Hulk. Because this is the first time we're seeing Mark Ruffalo in the MCU, and even though that he gets some kind of development when it comes to losing his powers in Infinity War, it is gonna be a lot more awkward to think that he only appears in these movies only, aside from Thor Ragnarok. If you really ask me, if we actually see another sequel involving the Hulk himself, with Mark Ruffalo being the main focus, I want to see what kind of storyline they can do involving the Hulk himself. Let me just say this right now. I found Mark Ruffalo a really great actor in these movies, as much as his portrayal in the Hulk, but at the same time, if you completely look at how the Hulk would have been portrayed if Mark Ruffalo starred in The Incredible Hulk instead of Edward Norton, I can easily give an understanding towards the Hulk character a lot more. Granted, they're trying to give some kind of background development when it comes to off-screen chemistry involving Bruce Banner and his surroundings, since that he is no longer friends or having a love interest with the characters from The Incredible Hulk. But every time I completely look at his presence in this movie where he just left everything behind, it really feels a lot more awkward to think that The Incredible Hulk's purpose is mostly to have the Hulk have his own solo movie in the MCU. And considering that She-Hulk is mostly a show for a female character to take the lead while Mark Ruffalo is mostly a side character, it's gonna be a lot more awkward to see how that is gonna be portrayed with the budget it's gonna receive compared to a movie budget. As for Hawkeye in this film, since that he did appear in Thor, even if it was mostly a small cameo by also contributing Thor's depression and frustration on not being able to lift the hammer because he's not worthy. Him in this movie, I have to say that he has the least when it comes to development. I'm gonna say this right now, after watching a few people's reaction of Hawkeye being included in Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3, which I cannot believe I've mentioned an Angry Joe video in this video because they have a reaction of how characters will appear in popular video games during the time before this movie's released. I have to say that his presence in this movie is probably the least interesting when it comes to the Six Avengers. Yes, he's working with the Shield, but even around this time involving the MCU, they're still having a difficult time on adjusting the minor characters, and aside from Black Widow and the others, Hawkeye or Clint really had the less interest in when it comes to the development in phase 1. Granted, I wouldn't say that he's done poorly in this film, but at the same time, I can say that he's probably the least best Avenger in this entire film. When it comes to Leo films, he gets so much development, but in this film, being mostly his major appearance, I have to say that he really didn't do much other than the fact that he's mostly helping the other characters. Granted, he does the best action sequences, but on the other hand, the other characters did much more better action sequences than him. So you may think that this movie is considered the least best when it comes to the Avengers movies. I need to make one thing clear. The future Avengers movies have improvements when it comes to the cast of characters and the story writing. This really feels like a movie that came out in the 2000s or way before that, because it really feels like the writing is mostly how the characters meet each other while also dealing with an army, which is something that you would usually see from time to time. For me personally, that really holds this movie back, but on the other hand, I can still sit through this movie when it comes to watching the other Avengers movies. If it wasn't for the action sequences and the amazing score from this film, this movie would have been easily forgettable. But on the other hand, we should really never forget for how much this film really appreciates the fan service they gave us. It's really probably the best fan service that has done right when it comes to any of these types of franchises. The bits where we could really see the Avengers facing off the army really takes up much when it comes to the final 10 or 20 minutes of this film. It's one of the best moments from not only from the first phase, but almost all the MCU movies. Granted, you can say when it comes to how they improve the action sequences and the animations, but I can easily tell that they really did what they could in order to make the animation, not to mention the effects in this, way more superb since that this is the finale of Phase 1. Every time I look back at these sequences, it never gets old because it's the biggest highlight in the first phase. Granted, it's better when it comes to other future movies, but when it comes to other films that aren't the Avengers, then this will probably be one of the best moments in any other film when it comes to cinema. And I'm pretty sure that there's no other film in the future would take the elements from this movie and turn it into something extraordinary, because it's not really possible. I have to admit that this movie made me appreciate the MCU a lot more. Granted, I don't usually watch all the movies, which is mostly gonna be a debate once I watch the other MCU movies after the first phase. But on the other hand, I can easily tell that the Avengers movie really made me appreciate of what the MCU is really capable of. So after watching the previous five movies, I have to say that the build-up in this movie really does its job right. Granted, I wouldn't recommend this movie when it comes to people who aren't into the MCU before they watch the other five films, but if you're into the Avengers and you want to watch this movie by getting into the Avengers, then go right ahead. But let me just say this right now, you're gonna be missing out what the other films have in store, mainly the solo films of Iron Man, Captain America, and Thor. And with Phase 1 complete, we're getting into Phase 2 in November. I give this movie a 9 out of 10.
Let's get this started again, again, again. Me and my whole crew.